One of the biggest arguments you can get in the world of cameras is color science and how things look. Now, me personally, I've done podcasts about this. Once I get that image knocked around, beat around how I want with colors and saturation and desaturation, the color science of the camera doesn't really matter too much to me, but I always hear about how hard it is to color grade on Sony cameras. I've gotten that argument as well. I don't really feel that way. I'm going to show you how easy it is to color grade in Adobe Premiere Pro. Now, back to the arguing part. Someone is going, why aren't you using DaVinci Resolve to color grade? While that is undoubtedly the best app on the market to color grade in, it is Hollywood Award winning. DaVinci Resolve is not without its problems. Like, if your computer doesn't have a graphics card that can handle it, you're in a little bit of trouble when using that software, but it's totally free and I recommend it, and it is making strides to become an all-in-one editing software package, not just this weird round robin thing we've had to do forever to only use the color grading inside DaVinci Resolve and then go back to Final Cut Pro or Adobe Premiere Pro, whatever we were using to edit with before. With the video on some DSLR cameras and the mirrorless cameras being what they are, I think we could be at a point where the video game industry and review industry of video games got where they just quit putting grades on graphics, because it's gonna have its own merits to it regardless by the time the finished product comes out. Sort of similar thing right here. I'm not really worried about how that image quality is going to be on some of these cameras like the Sony A7 III that I'm on right now. It's more, how will I get that color grade where I want it to fit the mood and emotion for the story or whatever message I'm trying to get across. So I used to mess this up in color grade clip by clip, edit, copy, paste, 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 paste. That was sort of the wrong way to do this. The simplest thing in the world to do is what I'm about to show you with an adjustment layer in Adobe Premiere Pro. This first bit is a bit important. You want to be inside of the project panel because that's where you'll get access to new items and a little crinkled up paper look. Pick the adjustment layer, make sure it fits the size of your project. And I'm just going to lay it on top of my video file that I want to color grade. Then it's time to go into the color panel. And at top, you will see options for Rec 709, which I always wonder, when people complain about how hard it is to color grade, do they go inside of this panel? Adobe Premiere Pro comes with these presets. You see the adjustment layer on top, and here's the flat picture profile or the log profile that I use to shoot on A7 III. Actually, it's the log 2 profile because there's several profiles that you can use. This is the flat S-log 2 that I use. Adjust that adjustment layer over the top and then go into individual clips if necessary to tweak those even further, like the white balance. I have a little bit of high exposure in the dynamic range, I can bring it back. And you also have your secondaries you can go into with the creators. Slap another filter on there and tweak those as well, and get things like saturation here, get that right where you want it to further put another color grade on that clip, and you're good to go. And that's all there is to it. Thank you for watching this video. It means so much that you hung out with me for a few seconds here on this quick talk. Hit that like button if you like and subscribe to never miss a shot from YeagerShots.com.